In this video, I will be talking about how to apply for the Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador program. This program is the perfect platform for networking and learning all sorts of new technologies with like-minded people. To be a part of this prestigious family, your first step is to apply for the program. Let me walk you through the process of application now. Your first and foremost step would be to visit the official page of the Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador program. The link on the screen would be where you should land first. To be able to apply and go forward, you will, however, have to log in with your existing Microsoft account or simply create one if you don't already have it. Following this, please click Apply Now and you will see the following screen. Now, this is your main page where you will have to complete every single requirement and then submit the form. However, one thing to be noted is that you may fill your application in intervals since the application will get auto-saved and you can pick up from where you left off. So the first two tabs that you will have to go to would be the application notifications and the privacy terms. Make sure to read them thoroughly as they consist of critical information. The application notifications tab consists of information about when your application will be applicable and what cohort you will be joining in as a Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador if you apply by then. The privacy terms involve the basic mandatory requirements of the program and what you must follow after being a part of this program. Three basic requirements are, however, that you need to be at least 16 years of age, enrolled in a full-time college or university and have a valid identification. You then agree and wish to continue and move forward with your application. The next two tabs will require your basic information, both personal and academic institution information. Please make sure to fill extremely authentic information because this is again crucial if you want to be selected in the program. Now comes another very essential part of the application. You will have to answer all the three questions either through a video presentation or even just writing a paragraph about it. Make sure that when you take a video, your voice is clearly heard and there is no background noise. In addition to this, the video should be within the time limit of 2 minutes and thus should not go overboard. It is a subconscious impression that you tend to make on evaluators, so keep that in mind. Now let's go about the questions one by one. Personally, I would suggest that you send in videos for both Inspire and Teach. This is because the first question asks you for what excites you about technology. And only when you talk about it, people can understand the emotion that you hold towards it. It will show the evaluators your passion and enthusiasm for technology. Make sure you send a video for this one if it's possible. Also, coming to the teach category, you are expected to teach a concept here. Now, the concept you pick could be as basic as loops in a programming language of your choice to even any Azure technology that you have worked on. However, what technology you pick doesn't make the difference. The way you pass on this information and ensure that people understand is what matters the most. So please think out of the box and make the process engaging. Again, voice modulation matters a lot, and that is the reason why I suggested that you send in a video for this question too. It will reach the listeners in a more crisp manner. The last question can be answered via a video or just a text paragraph. This question revolves around how you plan to reach people when you decide to do an event. So it's still okay to send in a text paragraph for this one. Now the questions you choose to send in a video for and the ones you choose to just type down your answer is totally dependent on you. And this was just a mere suggestion I decided to give everyone watching this. But make sure, and this is very important, one video is the minimum requirement. No matter what, you have to send in one at least. You can upload this video either on YouTube, OneDrive, or Google Drive. It's completely up to you, but make sure to make the link public. Now, this constitutes the major part of your application. After this, you move on to the social media website links page. Make sure to give all your accounts here. Do not get intimidated if you don't maybe have an account on a particular website. But ensure that if you have it, you put it up. Also, it's okay if you think you don't have great contributions on your GitHub profile or great experience on your LinkedIn profile. Still, just put it out there. This is a process of learning, and with time, we will all get there. In the additional information section, add in every technology that you are interested in, because in this program, we have a concept of leagues, wherein like-minded technology enthusiasts come together and work on technologies they're really interested in and also share resources. With that, you will be done. And make sure that you have answered all the required fields, and then you can finally submit your application. Make this application as authentic as possible. It is a way for your evaluators to know the kind of person that you are. I hope everyone watching this has benefited from this. Apply soon, and thank you.